he will put it actually into quotes. The issue of IPA, Investment Promotion Agency, which actually took a lot of discussions whether it's a separate entity or not a separate entity, we ended at the end, it's like a business, it's like a Gavi IPA. We need really the objective here to separate the investment promotion than the regulatory issues, especially if Gavi will be more involved into the one-stop shop and the activities related to operation and licenses, which will take a lot of effort. We have to separate the promotional side. We need to do the promotional from an investment bank's viewpoint, which is really working on a real investment map of Egypt that is related to the government. And this investment map will be endorsed on a yearly basis from the cabinet of ministers. So from a high level, it will be endorsed. This is related to the government policy itself, doing sectorial studies, doing research on where is the gap analysis, where is the market and the supply and the demand, so that to guide investors. This is a role really is missing now in current Gavi promotional activities. We are only doing the matchmaking ideas. However, we need to build on that in a more professional way. That's why it will be a business unit, a separate business unit, still under Gavi. However, from an administrative and financial issues, again, this is part, again, of the executive regulation we are working on now, yani how to make such organizational structure in an easy way. The main overall goal of such amendments really is to provide an equal access and simplify the procedures and a simplified environment for the investment. We hope so. Definitely, it's a learning curve again. This government is learning from the market. We have no problem in that. We have a very recent case regarding this stock exchange tax policies issues. So we are working on the executive regulation. Timeline probably within 2 weeks it will be released. And then we'll see how really the implementation side. We believe that automation plays a very important role in this one-stop licensing and operational requirements, procedures, etc. We believe also pilot on different sectors. We are working on pilot in the agriculture sector, followed by one in the logistics sectors. We are having a meeting today, for example, with the World Bank and the IFC later today. They are working with us on a project regarding this simplification and ease of the environment. Process. We have applied, Government of Egypt has applied for funding Deauville Partnership last April related to that project because it's, we believe without an international experience and technical assistance, we will not move forward really with such a procedures related to simplifying the investment framework. Thank you very much. This is just. Well, this is quite a difficult question. I agree with you. Yani, it's one of the critiques and comments, negative comments given on the amendments, issued amendments, was related to this Article 14, which is canceling labor rights for 10%, I believe, as a part of the profit sharing. Then this has been recently, I believe, yes, on 7th of May, there has been a real change in that. We are trying to deal with it in the executive regulations now, but it's still under discussion, to tell you the truth. We know it's an issue between two different, we are trying to encourage investments, but still we have to keep with the employers, with the employees' rights related to that, yeah. It's not a very clear answer to you, anyway. I'm trying to be a little bit politician here. The vision is not yet identified, really, and it's regarding this point, yeah. That's why it will be. Actually, the government, there was a revised which was issued on the 7th. Have you seen that on the 7th of May? Actually, we met, there was the government, this one was issued, the amendment was issued on the 15th of March, I believe, or 13th of March, something like that. The details, no. But there is a recent amendment to the amendment, which was released on 7th of May.
Yeah, that's the same.
Yeah.
Yeah. The
which was
translation is very bad.
On the 7th, yeah. One of it actually is that GAFI has discovered, which is frankly, is part of this free zones, they have to collect duties. So 1%, I believe, service duties, resume, and so on. And it was dropped in the amendments. So part of GAFI now the revenue, which is you are building actually on investing more into automation and investing into the promotion and improving the process. So we added back that to the content. And also we added this employer's, this employee right, the point you are talking about. It's not no tax. We hold it for 2 years. For 2 years. Yani like a grace period. Yani like an. Yani we'll see the. No, not for a while. We'll work on a more independent studies related to those issues raised by taxes, etc. And it needs more deep analysis. This will come into an executive regulations. The decision 2 days ago, actually, it has to be drafted into a law. You cannot stop tax anyway by a decree, with just a normal cabinet decree. That's what the government is currently, the cabinet is working on it. And it will detail those executive, retroactive or not, and it's an... there is a lot of influx of information. I don't want to give an excuse for the government, but you are working on a different levels, whether a level of disputes and problem, whether it's level of new legal reforms. It's not this is the only reform laws we are working. We are working on companies, update of the companies law, customs law, value added tax, the VAT, executive regulation for the mining law, and energy or electrical liberalization for the market law and allowing for more IPPs and selling to consumers, etc. directly. So there is an influx of information that probably the decision maker here or the economic committee, it needs to take its time, and instead of releasing very quickly. In a frank way. No, the re-amended again was just changes in some of one or two clauses, just an linguistic. There are some of them were linguistic, even khata, lagawiyan, one or two of those items. Yeah. And for transparency, we have to say that, and we have to publish it in the National Gazette. Yeah.
I would like to share as well a few of my experiences, not just in Egypt, but as well on the national level, but to reply to what you said in the beginning, that it takes about 2 to 3 days to get a company registered. This is under the condition that you have your papers right.
Oh, yeah. Course, yeah.
Otherwise,
Shada Bankaya, bank, you paid the capital in the bank, shareholders agreement signed. There are certain procedures you have to follow.
This one is self-understood. And here, really, the devil is in the details, and it will be much easier for a local Egyptian investor to get his papers done. But if you are a foreigner, then you have this whole complex of consulate legalization, certification, and like this one. And we feel that Egypt could make things easier if they would become a signatory state of the Hague Convention for the legalization of diplomatic documents. Mm. Very simple right now, if a German company wants to invest in Egypt and has any documents that require legalization by a notary public,
okay.
Then this legalization from the notary public needs a cross legalization by the local regional court first.
Okay.
Then with this you have to go to the consulate. Mm. Then you come to Egypt and you have to go to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and only then you can really make use of this document, simply because the document is in the beginning considered only from the German legal realm, so it has no validity like that. If Egypt would sign this one, you could straight use a document that is certified by the notary public to the embassy, and then it passes by like this. So, this is important because it's not just that you have to legalize and extract from the commercial registrar, you have translations. And if the embassy feels that the translation is not precise, then the whole thing is rejected. And then you start again from the very beginning.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Here you have sometimes a situation that it takes you 2 or 3 months until you have your documents only in Germany ready. Then you get the consular legalization, and then you can start here this process. So that could be one of the amendments. Another thing is as well, it is good that we have a lot of lawyers here who are available to advise investors. But in an ideal world, me as an investor, I can walk straight into GAFI and I get the chance to get a standard company formation done like that. But that would require that you find someone, if I'm a Chinese, who can talk to me in Chinese. If I'm a French, who can talk to me in French. If I'm German, I'm happy because I have Sahar who can talk in German to me. Yeah? But if today, if I'm walking into GAFI, I find myself in the same line with all the local investors. And then sometimes you have, of course, officers who speak just Arabic. And that is the end of the project for an investor because he can no longer not communicate. So it would be good to have tellers just for the foreign investors and tellers for the local investors so that you can separate this client traffic, and you can then have, of course, specially trained officers who know how to deal with foreign cultures. You can mediate a lot at this stage.
Definitely.
An idea. We did, in the preparation of the president's visit to Germany, an inquiry about a poll among our members, and they come up with a maybe funny suggestion, but with a good suggestion. They say, why don't you put all the laws and regulations online, free of charge? The idea behind this one is that sometimes you meet a local administration who have a quite deliberate interpretation of the laws and regulations, and because you don't know what the original regulation is, then you are totally in the hand of the officer. Mm. But if this one is published and it can be downloaded, then you can say, here, Mr. Customs Officer, this is the regulation. It's not what you're telling me. So it would be...
But this is falls under the umbrella of easing and simplified environment and easy access. Yeah. Our proposed like project we are working on now, Jan. But
so, because as
this time,
now,
yeah.
Yeah, as you are now in the process of reforming everything, it could be...
You should have such...
And the final thing is an experience that I had... I have been working for 10 years in Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia. And the Malaysian government, they had something they called MITI dialogue from Ministry of International Trade and Industry. It was shared by the industry minister. So in Egypt, such a dialogue could be chaired by the Minister of Investment. And then they were collecting all the complaints from investors. This meeting was attended by the International Chambers of Commerce. So to streamline this one, you cannot have hundreds of the company representatives there, and then those problems were presented, and on the other side of the table you had the representatives of all the authorities, from police to customs to regulations, and then the administration had about 2 months to reply to these complaints and either to solve it or to reject it, like this one. And these were really tough sessions because if you dare to raise an unfounded complaint, then the minister was killing you in place. But if it was a founded complaint, then the minister was following up. And this took a lot of problems out of these disputes because it was a forum that was created for the investors' community. And after a while...